Shared ownership just inverts the relationship of people at work in the modern world, where in the modern world, they show up in the business plan as an expense and on the books, and they're to be minimized. They are a commodity, they don't have an agency. And to not have agency to start with, to be just a commodity, that's pretty dehumanizing. To also be those who do have agency seeing you as a cost that they're hoping to reduce, so there's actually an animosity underlying the structure of a business with those workers, unless someone chooses to try to change it. That can be famously a very dehumanizing context to be in. And to reverse that, some of the workers are the agents. And so they're not working for the benefit of capital, to maximize the extraction of profit. But actually the capital's working for them, where they can use capital as a tool, which is great. The idea that one tweak of let's invert the relationship of who owns the business, who's the business there for, could change so much. It's just one of those, what we see is it's like a linchpin tool, it's a keystone kind of tool. It hits at a keystone of a problem. It's meant to have all sorts of ripple effects within an economy. So to me, worker ownership is a part of the idea of a just society. You also can have community ownership. You have multi-stakeholder ownership. You have, there's different ways to share ownership, but by exploding the model where only investors own, which really is like saying only capital owns, and all investment is really only for the maximization of profit for capital, and exploding that and talking about ownership in a different way, talking about ownership even as stewardship, where even those who own it are stewarding it for the next generation who should own it. It allows you to think those ways, and it sort of breaks open like a prism all the possibilities of just economy. So for me, worker ownership, it's one of the key crucial tools in changing our economy and bringing justice and sacredness into the center.